no one is doing a true representation of Indian food. So, you know, you'll get the same thing, you'll get the dal makhani, you'll get the butter chicken, which, mind you, is all Indian food. But, you know, what about the food from Orissa, or what about the food from Kashmir? We really wanted to do something that really highlighted the complexity and the depths of Indian food.
This Great Big Story was made possible by Incredible India.
My name is Adit Maheshwari. I'm the head chef at Cafe Lota. I have always been very keen about food. I've been very interested in food. I remember what I ate when I was 4 or 5 years old. What I try to do whenever I'm traveling is to eat at places which are off the beaten path, in the back alleys, people's homes. So that's the way I actually got to taste some of the lesser known dishes that a lot of people would not know, even in India. So Cafe Lota is in the National Crafts and Handicrafts Museum. The concept of Cafe Lota is highlighting regional Indian food, food that you wouldn't necessarily have seen in restaurants before. From the east, we do this prawn curry, which is called a chinguri karamanga khatta. And the main flavors of this dish is kashundi, which is a strong mustard that's used in Bengal and in Odia cooking. And the dish is also flavored with star fruit. From south, we do this very light, flavorsome chicken stew, which comes from the Syrian Christians. From the west, we do this roasted papad in a curry, along with a guava sabzi and a very crisp, wholesome flatbread. Worli tribe is a tribe that lives on the borders of all these central regions, and they're really famous for their wall painting. So their meat curry, while has very simple ingredients, but it's really flavorful. Goat meat curry cooked in a coriander and mint curry with finger millet roti. The most popular dish here at Cafe Lota is our palak patta chaat. Because we are in Delhi, we're in the north, we have a palate for exciting chaat-like flavor, that play of sweet, spicy, sour. Indian culture revolves around food. The common thread that binds Indian cuisine is our use of spices, our balance of spices, and that, that inherent knowledge, I would say it's in our genes about what spice to use at what point of cooking, is what binds all Indian cooking together. The best compliment we received from an elderly person is a gentleman. He ate our vegetable stew and he came and said that, this is exactly like the way my grandmother used to make it. So that was, a great pat on the back for us.